Hey guys, and welcome back to a new video. This is actually a pretty simple video. It's two parts. The first part is a raw footage of me doing a Vo2 Max test. I had a step test and then a Vo2 Max test. So it's just a raw footage of that test, and in part two you have my coach Alexander Skelt that talks about the test, the Vo2 Master and the Moxy sensor, and our philosophy in training. So enjoy.
Du trenger ikke å si noe, men nå setter jeg den på 4.30, så spør jeg etter 2 minutter. Får du tommel opp hvis jeg skal...
All right.
Ja, jeg må bare stille meg litt ut, og så... Nå setter jeg den på 4.30, egentlig, da. Vi
klar. Du klar?
Ja.
Ok. Da øker jeg den.
Jeg må bare holde hele.
Vi går rett på 4.30, da.
Ja.
Der vi i gang. Kjør på. Kom igjen nå.
Kom igjen nå. 4 minutter, så fortsetter du. Kom igjen nå. Kom igjen. Fortsett. Fortsett, kom igjen. Ikke gi deg. Ikke gi deg. Slukk videre. Bare fortsett nå, så lenge du klarer. Kom igjen. Du skal til 4.30. Du skal til 4.30. Kom igjen. 4.30. Kom igjen. Kom igjen. Hold deg gående. Kom igjen. Ikke gi deg. Ikke gi deg. Kom igjen. 15 sekunder til. Kom igjen. Kom igjen. Kom igjen. Vær på 5 sekunder til. Kom igjen nå. Kom igjen. Kom igjen. Kom igjen. Kom igjen. Fortsett. Kom igjen nå. Det er bra. Prøve 5. Kom igjen. Tråkk, 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 tråkk. Ikke stopp, ikke stopp. Opp med frekvensen, kom igjen. Hold frekvensen gående. Kom igjen, kom igjen.
Nydelig. Bra pusher på slutten her. Satan.
Hi guys. I'm here with Cedric. He visited us today. He's actually at my home. I am his coach, Alexander, and I've been coaching him for the last couple of years. We just finished a full step test and VO2max test, which went really good compared to his last test in July. So we're really excited. As he's starting his cycling career with Team Coop, it's going to be really great. And right now we are at a really good position. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about the test we did today. Are you happy?
Yeah, I think my progression over the last couple of weeks have been pretty good, and it was nice to get some new numbers we can work with for the coming weeks.
Yeah, absolutely. And we tested the VO2 Master for the first time. I just got it at home, that's why we're doing it here. So we didn't get a time slot in the lab this time. So he came to my place instead, and it worked really good. So yeah, I think that's what we're going to do forward also.
Yeah.
All right, here you see the test report. This is what you get when you finish the test. I'm going to show you, this is how the screen looks, and you can press the view report, and we're going to choose 30 second, which is more normal, and then go in, and then you get the test report, which is what Cedric did today. It shows the VO2 max, which was, I think, the highest we've recorded so far, 89.7, which was a little bit surprising since we've been training mostly below threshold or around threshold. The main focus has been extensive, long aerobic threshold workouts, supplemented with long threshold workouts. So we have been doing two types of main workouts. That's been the primary focus, LT1 and LT2, aerobic and anaerobic threshold, and almost nothing above anaerobic threshold. So this is really good that the VO2 max also increased. If we scroll down, we got all these graphs showing, and this is what, when you choose 30 seconds average, that shows how much noise you get in the graph. So this first graph shows the VO2 on each step, and then on the max for the last interval here, which in addition to having the highest VO2 max, he also had the highest average power. On this last, he ended in 490 watts for the last minute, roughly, which is really good. We think that this is also due to the longer extensive workouts, that the capacity to hold a higher power for a longer period of time has increased. That's really, really interesting. And then the next, so this is actually the same graph, and then this shows you more about how his control of breathing is. You have the VE, which is the exhaled volume of air, liters per minute, and then you have the RF, which is the breath frequency in breaths per minute, and then the tidal volume, which is the liter per breath. So actually the VE is equal to the tidal volume times the breath frequency. That's what you get, the total volume per minute. And you see how it increases a lot during the VO2 max, which is correct. And then it should increase steadily, but the frequency doesn't increase that much until he really starts to struggle at the end of the VO2 max. But there is a slight increase in breath frequency, which is pretty good, and his tidal volume also increases slightly. So it looks like he has pretty good control of his breath and his technique while breathing. And then the last graph shows the fraction of expired O2, FeO2. So this means how many liters of air you breathe out per liter of oxygen. So when he is working at low intensity, below LT1 or aerobic threshold, he roughly expires around 23, 24 liters of air per liter of oxygen. Yeah, that's a breakthrough of all the data that you get from this test report, which is interesting. We don't have CO2 yet, but we still get a lot of valuable information, and then we also have lactate, which is really helpful in determining the thresholds. We usually work with the principle that anaerobic threshold, which is the LT2 or what you usually refer to as threshold, is simply the spot where the lactate has the lactate maximum steady state, so the highest lactate level you can have while it keeps steady for an extensive period of time, maybe 30 minutes or more, or at least 30 minutes or more. It should be fairly steady. So we try to pinpoint that using this test, and then we check it in training afterwards. This is the final slide we're going to show you today. This is actually, we can see the rough data. This hasn't been processed in any way, and we just took it by visual inspection during the test, so the VO2 measurements here aren't correct. But you can see the lactate on each power, or corresponding to each step in the step test. And we did average power, the first step was 220 watts. And then for each of the 8 steps, we increased by 20 watts. And then you can see how the lactate increases or decreases for the first step down to 0.9. And then we find the aerobic threshold, which is the first deflection point where the lactate starts to increase, somewhere between 240 and 260 watts. So that's going to be his working point for LT1 going forward. And then we have the anaerobic threshold, which we have to control, as we said earlier, but it's probably around 320 watts. Just looking at how the lactate increases from 1.5 to 2.6, that's a 0.6 increase. And then from 2.1 to 2.4, that's 2.5, sorry, that's only a 0.4 increase. So it doesn't increase exponentially yet, so it's more likely slightly above 320 watts than below, which is really good if you look at some of the earlier tests we did. So 320, 2.5, just this July, he did 311 watts with 4.0, so that's at least a 15 to 20 watts increase in his threshold power. So that's very good. And then for the end part, he had 360 watts, which was still controlled. We actually tested lactate both in the ear and in the fingertip, and there was a little bit of a difference, which is interesting. 0.6 is a bit of a difference, but the intensity was also very high, so the lactate has increased a lot. Maybe it takes a little bit longer for the lactate to become steady or reach its maximum point in the finger compared to the ear. But previously he has been around 8, sometimes 7, you can look 7.5, so this is more or less the lowest he has been on the last step, which is also good. So we're going to analyze this later and use this to make a plan for his training going forward, but we're definitely going to increase or keep doing the same for another couple of months before preparing for race season. So ask Cedric any questions, and if you can't answer it, you can always ask me.
Very good. So thanks for watching. See you in the next one. GG. Stress. Unga röker bra utanför fritidsgården. Tjackisen står och dyrkar något av blåsen.